The successful line of Sikorsky Aircraft's long-running CH-53 series of helicopters found renewed emphasis in the 21st century with its latest iteration, the unmatched King Stallion. As an evolution of its predecessors, the CH-53K King Stallion resulted from 50 years of development and operational excellence. Able to carry up to 36,000 pounds on its single center-point cargo hook, the robust helicopter entered service with the U.S. Marine Corps as the service's main heavy-lift helicopter just in time. In the fall of 2021, an MH-60S got stuck in the White Mountains of California, and there was only one aircraft powerful enough to retrieve it. As Lieutenant Colonel Luke Frank, leader of Marine Operational Test and Evaluation Squadron 1, stated, quote, "This is exactly what the K is meant to do. Heavy lift is a unique and invaluable mission for the Marine Corps. Horsepower is our weapon system, and the CH-53K is armed to the teeth." The original. In 1962, the U.S. Marine Corps launched a heavy helicopter experimental competition, with Sikorsky's S-65 emerging victorious over Boeing Vertol's modified CH-47. The prototype, named YCH-53A, took to the skies in October of 1964 and eventually received the designation of Sea Stallion. The original model was powered by two T-64 GE6 turboshaft engines, which enabled a maximum takeoff weight of 42,000 pounds. The successful helicopter did not take long to branch out into several variants. For one, the U.S. Navy employed the RH-53A and RH-53D for minesweeping operations. Although all the H-53 variants used the General Electric T-64 engine, it was the CH-53D that was equipped with the most powerful version and also featured external fuel tanks. Meanwhile, the Air Force used HH-53BC, or Super Jolly Green Giants, which were deployed in special operations and combat rescue. Furthermore, its MH-53HJM Pavlo, fitted with extensive avionics upgrades for all-weather operations, was the final twin-engined H-53. Not really unsatisfied by the Sea Stallion's performance, but eager to have a more powerful machine, the Marine Corps issued another requirement toward the end of 1967. The service required a helicopter with a lifting capacity 1.8 times that of the CH-53D and wanted the aircraft to fit on an amphibious assault ship. Luckily for them, Sikorsky had already been working on a project of its own. A new proposal. The enhanced CH-53D that Sikorsky had been working on for some time was designated S-80, and it featured a third turboshaft engine topped by a more powerful rotor system. When Sikorsky presented the design to the Marines in 1968, the service approved it and funded the development of a testbed helicopter. Even so, the model saw several changes in the process, such as more robust transmission and a longer fuselage by 6 feet 2 inches. In addition, the main rotor blades were built in titanium fiberglass composite, while the vertical tail was also enlarged and the tail rotor tilted upward slightly, providing some lift in hover. Finally, a new automatic flight control system was installed. The first YCH-53E was ready to fly in 1974, and after passing all its tests, production began in 1978. However, the new helicopter would not go into service until 1981. In total, the Marines and the Navy acquired 177 models. Yet, for the Airborne Mine Countermeasures role, the Navy requested a CH-53E variant, the MH-53E Sea Dragon, with enlarged sponsons and fuel tanks. For all its success, the CH-53E would eventually be phased out. The Marine Corps would begin to retire it in the 2000s, and now needed a timely replacement, as its fleet would reach structural life limits no later than 2012. While the Marines originally planned to upgrade its fleet to retain most of its models, the effort stalled in favor of a new proposal. Once more, Sikorsky came forward with an innovative design, simply called CH-53X, and the service signed an $18.8 billion contract in 2006. The plan was to receive 156 CH-53K helicopters by 2021, but the order was eventually increased to 227. Soon, the model would become the USMC's main heavy-lift helicopter. unmatched capabilities. By 2008, the design work was well underway. Weight reduction efforts were needed to meet operational requirements, while the rotor mass tilt had to be decreased and components shifted to preserve the center of gravity as fuel burned. By the fall of 2010, the CH-53K passed the critical design review and was ready for test production. Sikorsky delivered the first CH-53K ground test vehicle airframe within 2 years, and the manufacturer soon focused on the development of 4 prototypes. The first 2 would test structural flight loads, while the other 2 would validate general performance, propulsion, and avionics. On May 5th, 2014, the mighty helicopter was officially rolled out, and its name was announced, King Stallion. Then, in October of the following year, the aircraft made its first flight. King Stallion would eventually achieve an important milestone, lifting a payload of 36,000 pounds in March of 2018. It proved to be the maximum weight on the single center point cargo hook. In the words of the manufacturer, quote, "We've flown more than 1,200 test flight hours, and the CH-53K has achieved key milestones in 2018, such as high altitude, hot temperature, and degraded visual environment flights, and we will continue to accomplish test points, demonstrating this aircraft's unmatched capabilities." When the first CH-53K was delivered to the Marine Corps, combat readiness was unexpectedly delayed due to technical flaws found in testing, and the program had to undergo major restructuring, pushing deliveries back. The exhaust gas was sucked back up by the engines instead of clean air, causing overheating and system stalling. But after fixing this and several other flaws, the King Stallion was finally ready to serve. Built to thrive. As a general redesign of its predecessor, with enhanced General Electric GE-38-1B engines, the King Stallion achieved over twice the lift capacity and radius of action of the CH-53E. Notably, it can even carry a Humvee. As Lockheed Martin explained, quote, "The CH-53 helicopter has been designed and built to the exacting standards of the U.S. Marine Corps and will serve as its critical land and sea-based logistics connector. The new heavy lifter will allow the U.S. Marine Corps and international militaries to move troops and equipment from ship to shore and to higher altitude terrain more quickly and effectively than ever before." Its improved digital glass cockpit layout includes fly-by-wire controls and haptic feedback, a health and usage monitoring system, and a new elastomeric hub system. Moreover, its composite rotor blades remarkably improved hot and high performance. The King Stallion split torque gearbox with quill shafts, with its rotor hub and rotating control system, weighs 11,650 pounds, a significant difference when compared to the MEAL Mi-26's 8,020-pound gearbox. In addition, the new model has an improved external cargo handling system that is nearly 30% larger than its predecessor, over the same radius of 110 nautical miles. And its 30-foot-long, 9-foot-wide, 6.5-foot-tall cabin is 15% larger. Moreover, the modern helicopter showcases enhanced survivability and extended service life. The company added, quote, "Built to thrive on the modern battlefield, including shipboard operations, the CH-53K aircraft is designed to be intelligent, reliable, low maintenance, and survivable in the most austere and remote forward operating bases." Request for assistance. On July 16, 2021, an MH-60S Nighthawk suffered a hard landing near Mount Hogue, California. The aircraft got stuck on a high-altitude ridge in rugged terrain at an elevation of 12,000 mean sea level while aiding in a search and rescue mission for a lost hiker. Although the 4 crew members were rescued by the following day, the helicopter remained inaccessible for several weeks. The MH-60S unit, the Naval Safety Center, the Army National Guard, the Navy, and the Marine Corps all exhausted their resources to recover it. It was then that Lieutenant Colonel Luke Frank, the CH-53K detachment officer in charge of the Marine Operational Test and Evaluation Squadron 1, or BMX-1, was notified of the incident. He recalled that, quote, "They all lacked the capability to lift the aircraft without an extensive disassembly." Soon after, the BMX-1 CH-53K detachment came to the conclusion that the mighty King Stallion could lift the entire stranded helicopter back to safety. The MH-60S weighed about 15,200 pounds and had to be carried over 23 nautical miles to the airport at Bishop. Having operated the CH-53 for half a year, Frank asserted, quote, "The detachment had every confidence in the aircraft's abilities to conduct the mission safely. Our main concern was the environmental factors ground support personnel would have to endure." The mission required 2 weeks of thorough planning, as well as assembling a team of over 25 Marines and sailors. But the true stars were the two CH-53Ks. The operation took 2 arduous days, but despite all the hardships, it was successful. It was also the first official fleet mission for the Marine Corps' new heavy lift capability. In Frank's words, quote, "To be the first group of professionals to complete a real-world heavy lift high-altitude mission in support of a unit who thought all options were off the table is extremely rewarding. This is sure to be the first of what will be many, many successful missions for this aircraft and for heavy lift squadrons." Thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe to Dark Skies and hit the bell icon to be notified of our newest content. Also, don't hesitate to check out the rest of our Dark Documentaries channels, where we delve into the most fascinating battles in modern history and the technology used in them. Stay tuned.